and if you are more interested in science. So Richard Ibra, the making of a scientist. Straight away we start the chapter that this is about the making of a scientist. You know, overnight the success doesn't reach to anyone. The success is assured with continuous, constant effort, and then finally you reach your success point, right? So here you are studying about the making of a scientist. How a scientist is made. Scientist is Richard H. Ibright, has received the Surly Scholar Award and the Scarry Plough Award for Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. It was his fascination for butterflies. What I was talking about, the curiosity. The curiosity was regarding the butterflies that opened the world of science to him. See, butterflies, everyone of us see, they are just fluttering around. We love the colors. Usually we love the colors, the beauty and the rainbow wings. But one who goes beyond that was Richard Ibright. Right? So butterflies ne ek nayi duniya uske samne open kiya, ek naya horizon, ek naya scenario. At the age of 22, a former scout of the year. Scout jante, what is a scout? Anyone knows? Making padh rahe kaise scientist bana ho that you are going to study. So scout of the year, aapne dekha hoga kuch bachche na wo police wali uniform mein, khaki dresses mein, uniforms mein aapne dekha hoga. They are just like volunteers. NCC hota hai, National Cadet Corps. When you see the parade of Republic Day, then also you see these scouts marching on the Rajpath. Have you seen that? So they are selected from all over the country. And scout of the year award mila tha inhe at the age of 22. Excited the scientific world with a new theory. So puri scientific world mein he brought a revolution with his theory on how cell works. सेल काम कैसे करते हैं, सेल का वर्किंग आप जाके बॉडी के हमारे जो सेल्स हैं अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट, सो वहां पर सेल हमारा कैसे काम कर रहा है, दैट थ्योरी ही हैज ब्रॉट एक्चुअली. एंड हिज कॉलेज रूममेट एक्सप्लेन्ड, जो उनके कॉलेज रूममेट थे उन्होंने एक्सप्लेन किया था, हिज कॉलेज रूममेट explained their theory in an article in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. National Academy of Science tha, wahan par unhone is theory ko bataya tha. Right? National Academy of Science. Article print hua tha ye. It was the first, and Richard Ibright and unka college roommate. They both explained the theory, how the cell works. Cell ki working ki theory thi, that was explained by Richard Ibright and his college roommate, right? And article, the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science. It was the first time this important scientific journal, National Academy of Science, it was a journal. Journal, you know, it was a magazine, had ever published the work of college students. The first time was in the history of this journal that the work of college students had been published. In sports, that would be like making the big league. So that would be sports mein agar aap dekho na, it would be like making the big league at the age of 15 and hitting a home run your first time at bat. So bat jaise aap karte ho, batting karte ho, iska ek example hai home run in the, you can see baseball khelte hai jaise cricket mein sixer lagate hai, waise home league mein ye jo baseball khelte hai isme home run lagate hai, a big shot. That right, a home run in the game of baseball is when the batter, one who bats actually across a run, after running safely around all bases and back to the home flight without stopping. तो एक बड़ा score करते हैं जैसे, तो ये एक sixer लगाने जैसा success था for Richard Ibright कि उनका जो article था वो National Science, जो National Academy of Science की proceedings से उसमें publish हुआ था, right? So definitely at a young age a very big in the account of Richard Ibright. For Richard, it was the first in a long string of science. Long string. String, you know, string means ek mala ko bolte hain, right? Ek bahut bada achievement, ek bahut sequence of achievements he had in his account. So science ho dusre fields mein bahut successful rahe Richard Ibright, and it all started with butterflies. और इसकी शुरुआत अभी जो कहते हैं मुझे 22 में ये proceedings of the National Academy of Science में जब मेरा article publish हुआ, it all started with science. तो इसकी जो शुरुआत हुई वो कहाँ से हुई थी? इस मैगजीन के साथ. अब वो कहते हैं स्टार्टिंग मुझे ये जो स्टार्टअप मिला वो बटरफ्लाइज में मेरे इंटरेस्ट के साथ मिला. एन ओनली चाइल्ड, ही एन ओनली चाइल्ड मींस ही वाज द सिंगल चाइल्ड ऑफ हिज पेरेंट्स. सो फादर बहुत यंग एज में इनके चले गए थे. ही वाज नॉट हिज मदर, ओनली सिंगल मदर ब्रॉट हिम अप. सो एट एन ओनली चाइल्ड इब्राइट गॉट द नॉट ऑफ रीडिंग इन पेंसिल्वेनिया. यूएसए में एक स्टेट है पेंसिल्वेनिया और वहाँ एक सिटी है रीडिंग. So he was, he grew up there. There wasn't much I could do there, he said. He is the upright, he said, ki wahan aisa bahut kuch nahi tha mere liye karne ke liye. I don't have many opportunities over there. I certainly couldn't play football or baseball with a team of one. Because I was single, there was no one at all in the neighborhood. So akele to main nahi khel sakta tha baseball. Jo usually bachche khelte hai, jaise apni country mein cricket khelte hai, so there. In America, baseball and football are more famous than cricket. So there was no one single person tha main, so I couldn't play that games and sports. But there was one thing I could do. But ek cheez thi jo main kar sakta tha, and that was collect things. So he didn't get disappointed for being alone. Rather, he used it, he capitalized on it in his own favor, and he turned his interest into the direction of science. So collection start kiya, so he did, and did he ever? वो उन्होंने किया, did he ever interjection लगाया हुआ और क्या किया, right? इस interest ने, इस loneliness ने उनको क्या खुशी दी, क्या एक different thing दिया life में? Beginning in kindergarten, kindergarten is KG, right? KG से शुरुआत हुई थी उनकी upright collected butterflies with the same determination that has marked all his activities. So butterflies collect करने में भी उनको same commitment था. जैसा उनका सारा एक्टिविटीज में था. मींस ही वाज नॉट अ पर्सन हु वाज डिवोटेड टू अ सिंगल एक्टिविटी और सिंगल इंटरेस्ट. ही वाज अ मैन, ही हैज अ बायपोलर ब्रेन, बायपोलर ब्रेन था. सो ही कुड फोकस हिज अटेंशन ऑन मोर देन वन एक्टिविटी. सो सारी एक्टिविटीज को वो उतनी ही कमिटमेंट के साथ करते थे. ही ऑल्सो रॉक्स भी कलेक्ट करते थे, फॉसिल्स, यू नो, डिकेड प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स, फॉसिल्स भी कलेक्ट करते थे, कॉइन्स भी कलेक्ट करते थे. ही बिकेम एन ईगर एस्ट्रोनॉमर, एस्ट्रोनॉमर, क्यूरियस एस्ट्रोनॉमर भी बन गए थे. रात को बैठकर स्टार्स को स्टडी करना, टू समटाइम्स स्टार गेजिंग ऑल नाइट. एंड समटाइम्स इट हैपेंड कि फॉर द होल नाइट ही वाज डूइंग नथिंग, जस्ट गेजिंग एट द स्टार्स. सो दैट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट ही हैड अ ड्राइविंग क्यूरियोसिटी अलॉन्ग विद अ ब्राइट माइंड. सो फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट क्लास से उनके अंदर एक ड्राइविंग क्यूरियोसिटी थी, ड्राइविंग दैट वॉज forcing him, that was pushing him, वो curiosity along with a bright mind. Brilliant तो definitely he was, scientist है, brilliant by birth थे. So brilliant थे, curiosity more than that. Brilliant तो बहुत बच्चे होते हैं, but everyone doesn't turn to be a scientist. He also had a mother. So that is the most important thing of anyone's life. How your mother is contributing to your interest. Sometimes parents used to crush the interest of the of the kids because they but Bright's mother identified his interest and rather encouraged it. His interest in learning. She took him on trips. वो trips पर लेकर जाती थी. Bought him telescopes और ये नहीं कि toys and all नहीं खरीदती थी. She used to buy for him telescopes, microscopes, cameras, mounting materials. Mounting materials are like जैसे tripods होते हैं ना, जिस पर आप अपना ये camera and कुछ भी install करते हो. So as a mounting material on which these microscopes or telescopes could be fixed and used, and other equipment helped him in many other ways. So they opened up new opportunities of curiosity for him in his life. I was his only companion until he started school, his mother said. Mother ne kaha ki main sirf only companion thi, I was the single companion until he started school, means till the time he remained home, because we all know ki your first school is your home only. And the beginning of your career gets its seed from home only. And if you are encouraged at home, then definitely you grow up to be a very curious man and intelligent man. Then his mother ne kaha ki main only companion thi. After that, I would bring home friends for him. Main usko doston ko bhi ghar lati thi so that he could enjoy his life. But at night, we just did things together. but during night his friends couldn't come. So we, means Richard Wright and his mother, were the only people at home. So we just did things together. Richie, ये उनका nickname था. Richie was my whole life. So Richie मेरे लिए सब कुछ था. After father died, when Richie was in third grade. So third grade में थे Richie. Then उनके father की death हो गई तो मैं अकेली थे हम लोग घर पर. We were the only people there. And she, her son, spent almost every evening at the dining room table. और Richard Wright की mother and Richard almost every evening वो dining room में spent करते थे. If he didn't have things to do, and when he was means had nothing to do, कुछ करने के लिए नहीं होता था, I found work for him. तो मैं work ढूंढती थी उसके लिए, how to keep Richard busy. Not physical work, he doesn't say ना, just usual mothers बोलते हैं ना, कुछ और physical workout कर लो, कुछ help करा दो, घर के household chores you should do, not like that. I didn't make him busy in doing all this work, but learning things. मैं उनको टास्क देती थी. रिचर्ड की मदर उनको अलग अलग टास्क देती थी. लर्न दिस थिंग, लर्न दैट थिंग, समटाइम्स ज्योग्राफी, समटाइम्स साइंस, समटाइम्स फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री, अ डिफरेंट डिफरेंट सॉर्ट्स ऑफ थिंग्स व्हिच वर ऑफ हिज लेवल. हिज मदर सेड ही लाइक्ड इट. एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग वाज दैट रिचर्ड टुक इक्वल इंटरेस्ट इन द थिंग्स इन द टास्क्स व्हिच हिज मदर यूज्ड टू असाइन हिम. एंड दैट इज द वे the success is assured. When someone is supporting you, someone is giving you the encouragement, you should also reciprocate simultaneously with the same enthusiasm and positivity. And he wanted to learn. So, and slowly it happened, gradually it became his habit. And eventually, and learn he did. He did learning, he earned top grades in school. Because at home, he was schooled in a very nice way, he was tutored in a very nice way. So he obviously aisa bachcha to marks mein to definitely he was going to get the top grades. On everyday things he was just like every other kid. His mother said roz ki jo cheeze thi, means he was not rare, he was not extraordinary, but he was just like every other kid. By the time he was in the second grade, Ibright had collected all 25 species of butterflies found around his hometown. So ye five aapki book mein bhi you can see this catalog that has been given. 25 species of butterflies he collected. These were all which were found around his home. Jo reading ke aas paas ka area tha wahan par ye 25 species were available and he had collected all of them, right? So this probably would have been the end of my butterfly collecting, he said. Aur shayad yahan par is habit, is hobby ka, is interest ka end ho jana chahiye tha. Ideally it would have ended for everyone, but it did not happen with Ibright, and that turned him into a scientist. He said, but then my mother got me a children's book called The Travels of Monarch 10. Phir meri mother mere liye science book lekar aayi, isme kuch butterflies ke bare mein detail thi. Monarch is the name of a butterfly. Ye normal jo butterfly hoti is type ki waisi butterfly thi, right? Ek viceroy butterfly hota hai, uska shape is type ka hota hai, right? I'm not very good in making drawings, but I can give you an idea for that. Ki wo butterflies, Monarch 10 is the name of a butterfly. So the travels of Monarch 10, ye mana jata tha ki jo Monarch butterflies hai, they are migratory butterflies. So that book which told how Monarch butterflies migrate to Central America. So it was mentioned in the book that how Monarch butterflies migrate to Central America. Pennsylvania is on the other direction. So Central America jaati hai ye Pennsylvania se migrate karke. Ab now it was the reason of curiosity, bhi kyun jaati hai, why they move. So opened the world of science to the eager young collector. Eager means curious, young collector is the Ibright. Uske liye ek nayi duniya khul gayi, ek naya cheez thi uske samne. At the end of the book, readers were invited to help study butterfly. I guess this one. So at the end of the book, readers were invited to help study butterfly migration. He read the whole book, and at the end, the writer of that book had invited the readers to help study butterfly migrations. It was an open call. It was an invitation from the writer's side that if you are interested in butterflies, please let me help to explore the reasons for the migration of these butterflies, monarch butterflies. They were asked to tag butterflies for research by Dr. Frederick A. Oakhart of the University of Toronto, Canada. कैनेडा अमेरिका की नेबरिंग कंट्री, वहां पर यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ टोरंटो एंड देयर वाज डॉक्टर फ्रेडरिक ए ओखाट, इनका बहुत बड़ा कंट्रीब्यूशन. ये जो मोनार्क ट्रेवल्स ऑफ मोनार्क 10 था, इट वाज डॉक्टर ओखाट वाज द राइटर ऑफ दैट बुक एंड ही इनवाइटेड कि आप में से देवर आस्क्ड टू, उनसे कहा गया दोस हु आर रीडिंग माय बुक यू शुड टैग द बटरफ्लाइज फॉर रिसर्च. यू नो व्हाट इज टैगिंग? एनी आइडिया व्हाट इज द टैगिंग? दिस इज द वे द बर्ड्स आर टैग्ड. एक स्टिकर लगा दिया जाता है, राइट? ऐसे स्टिकर लगा देते हैं बर्ड पर एंड ही इनवाइटेड कि आप ऐसे टैगिंग कीजिए, राइट? सो दे वर आस्क्ड टू टैग बटरफ्लाइज फॉर रिसर्च बाय डॉक्टर फ्रेडरिक ए ओखाट. इब्राइट्स मदर रोट टू डॉक्टर ओखाट एंड सून इब्राइट वॉज अटैचिंग लाइट एडहेसिव टैग्स टू द विंग्स ऑफ मोनार्क्स. So, doctor को लिखा इब्राइट की माता ने. इब्राइट्स मदर वॉज ऑलवेज अ वेरी एक्टिव पार्टनर इन ऑल द थिंग्स दैट इब्राइट डू. सो ही रोट टू डॉक्टर ओखाट एंड सून रोट दैट ही इज इंटरेस्टेड इन डूइंग ऑल दिस. ही इज इंटरेस्टेड इन टैगिंग द बटरफ्लाइज एंड उसने लगाना शुरू किया अटैचिंग लाइट एडहेसिव टैग, जैसे आई शोड यू ना, अप ब्राउन छोटा सा टैग लगाना शुरू किया विंग्स ऑफ मोनार्क्स. So that the butterfly I showed you, that was the monarch butterfly. Anyone who found a tagged butterfly was asked to send the tag to Dr. Ockhart. So किसी को भी अगर, और ये clear किया गया कि जिसको भी ऐसी butterfly मिलता है, तो वो tag को वहाँ से निकालकर Dr. Ockhart के पास he should be sent. So he should send it. The butterfly collecting season around reading last 6 weeks in late summer. Late summer आप देखो तो ये आप graph में देख सकते हो. राइट, तो ये सिक्स वीक्स का इनका टाइम होता है. नंबर एंड काइंड्स ऑफ बटरफ्लाइज कलेक्टेड इन सिक्स वीक्स. तो स्नाउट उसने वन किया था, मोनार्क थ्री थे, मोनार्क वर वन अगेन, वाइट्स एंड सल्फर्स थ्री थे, राइट, एंड ब्रश फूटेड वुड नेम्स एंड स्टार्स अटायर एंड गुजामो विंग्ड. दीज वर द वेरियस बटरफ्लाइज विच वर कलेक्टेड एट दैट टाइम, राइट? So if you are the butterfly collecting season 6 weeks chalta tha wahan par. If you are going to chase them one by one, you won't catch very many. Agar aap one one karke unhe pakadne jaoge to so many won't be collected. He would catch a female monarch, take her eggs. So usne ek different way nikala. So the next step for Ibright was to raise a flock of butterflies. So ab one leke fir catch karna, usko tag karna, it won't give him much a good number of butterflies. So what he did that, उसने एक फीमेल मोनार्क को कैच किया, उसके एक्स लिए और इनको बेसमेंट में थ्रू देयर लाइफ साइकिल, और बेसमेंट में इनको थ्रू देयर लाइफ साइकिल फ्रॉम एग टू कैटरपिलर टू प्यूपा टू एडल्ट बटरफ्लाई. सो उनको रेस किया, राइट? उनको वहां पर रेस करना शुरू किया. तो फ्लॉक ऑफ बटरफ्लाइज ही कुड गेट इन दिस वे. देन ही वुड टैग द बटरफ्लाइज विंग्स, फिर उसने उनको टैग किया एंड लेट देम गो एंड इनको उड़ा दिया. For several years, his basement was home to thousands of monarchs in different stages of development. So, alag-alag stages aapne butterfly ki science mein, biology mein, you must have heard. You must have read also ki egg se fir caterpillar banta hai, fir pupa banega, then butterfly hoga. So, wo alag-alag butterflies ke wings ko tag karta tha and let them go. Several years, unke ghar mein basement tha. It was home to thousands of monarchs in different stages of development. Development ke alag-alag stages par the butterflies could be seen in the basement of Ibright's home. Eventually, means finally, I begin to lose interest in tagging butterflies. But slowly, you know, life becomes monotonous. If you are doing the same thing, following the same task, then it becomes monotonous and tiring. So he said, he admitted later that he began to lose interest in tagging butterflies. So butterflies ko tag karne mein, it was very tedious work. It tedious tha. Tedious means tiring tha. And there is not much feedback. Results बहुत अच्छे नहीं मिलते. When you are working continuously hard and you don't get the marks, you don't get the result for that. So definitely we feel more demoralized. So Ibright said, in all the time I did, he laughed. Only two butterflies. हंसते हुए बताते बड़े jolly mood में. He said that पूरा time मैंने ये सब कुछ किया, even raise किया, thousands of butterflies I tagged. Only two butterflies I had tagged were recaptured. जो मैंने tag लगाया था, only two were recaptured. So that is really very disappointing, and they were not more than 75 miles from where I lived. और वो migrate करके कहीं नहीं गए, सिर्फ 75 miles मेरे घर से दूर वो मिले, not more than that. डेफिनेटली काफी डिसअपॉइंटिंग था इतने क्यूरियस साइंटिस्ट के लिए. सो देन इन द सेवेंथ ग्रेड, सो देन व्हेन ही रीच्ड टू सेवेंथ ग्रेड ही गॉट अ हिंट ऑफ व्हाट रियल साइंस इज व्हेन ही एंटर्ड अ काउंटी साइंस फेयर. काउंटी मीन्स रीजन. एक रीजनल साइंस फेयर हुआ था. ही एंटर्ड दैट क्योंकि साइंस में इंटरेस्ट शुरू से था. एंड द क्रेडिट गोज टू डॉक्टर उर्खाट ऑल्सो, ही गेव अ डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन टू हिज इंटरेस्ट. सो ही सेड कि एक हिंट मिला उसे कि रियल साइंस क्या है. It was really a sad feeling to sit there and not get anything while everybody else had won something. So, us county science fair mein jitne log gaye the, so many people participated in that science fair. Everyone got something or the other. Right? Sabko kuch na kuch mila tha, but we didn't get anything. Reason? What was the reason? Ibright said, his entry was slides of frog tissues. Unki entry kya thi? It was this. I just show you that also. ये आप देखोगे ये frog के tissues थे. उन्होंने वो tissues निकाले frog के and microscope से इनको देखना था. Right? तो इसमें कोई interest नहीं था लोगों को, ना कुछ different था. तो he learned a lesson from here that he realized the winners had tried to do real experiments. कि जो विनर्स थे जिन्होंने जीता था कुछ ना कुछ देवर फ्रॉक टिश्यूज ने विच ही शोड अंडर अ माइक्रोस्कोप. ही रियलाइज कि जो विनर्स थे उन्होंने कुछ रियल एक्सपेरिमेंट किए थे, नॉट सिंपली मेक अ नीट डिस्प्ले. इब्राइट्स वाज अ नीट डिस्प्ले, जस्ट सी दीज टिश्यूज अंडर अ माइक्रोस्कोप. एंड ही थॉट दैट ही इट वाज अ गुड साइंस ऑफ वर्क ऑफ साइंस, बट द रियलिटी वाज डिफरेंट. एंड व्हेन यू आर एक्सपोज्ड, यू नो यहां पर व्हेन यू वांट टू गेट सक्सेस द फेलियर इज द स्टेपिंग स्टोन फॉर दैट. यू शुड ऑलवेज taste this failure, because then only you realize what is the taste of victory. Right? After failing in life or after losing at least something, then we really value the things. We really value the success. And that is what Ibright got here. He felt so disappointed at that time. Already the competitive spirit that drives Richard Ibright was appearing. So, yahan par develop hua ek naya competitive spirit. Because he was he was unhappy because he didn't get anything, and he was also very sad that how you feel when you lose a competition. So ye competitive spirit ne Richard Ibright ko drive kiya first appearing. He competitive spirit was starting taking shape in him. I knew that for the next year's fair I would have to do a real experiment. So he had realized and he had decided that for next year's fair, if I want to come into this fair again, or science mein kyunki interest tha, toh this fair, these kind of fairs were going to be a part and parcel of his life. So he decided that definitely I had to do some real thing. He said the subject I knew most. Ab mujhe ye bhi malum tha jis subject mein mujhe sabse zyada interest tha since my childhood was the insect. Ab insect hi hai jo mujhe de sakte the kuch. So I had been doing it the past several years kyunki main apni sari study jo tha wo insects par hi kar raha tha. So he wrote to Dr. Urquhart for ideas. So he invited or he wrote to Dr. Urquhart for some guidance. He said, please give me some idea which are the areas of insects in which I can discover the things. And back came a stack of suggestions. Stack means pile. A pile of suggestions mere paas aaya for experiments. You can do this, that, this. So many suggestions were given by Dr. Urquhart. Those kept Ibright busy all through high school. Seventh grade mein ye hua tha aur pura high school tak till 10th grade he remained busy in that and led to prize projects. And in his suggestions ne unko bahut sare prize projects ki taraf push kiya in county and international science fairs. So science fairs hue, county fairs hue, and they all originated from the ideas which were provided by Dr. Urquhart. Dr. Urquhart only provided the ideas. The culmination and the execution was all done by Ibright. For his 8th grade project, one after another unhone project liye 8th grade ke liye, Ibright tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. Caterpillar growing stage tha butterflies ka. So 8th grade ke liye jo project Ibright ne choose kiya was to cause a viral disease. Ek virus phailta tha aur ye virus corona jaisa to nahi tha, but ek aisa virus tha jo nearly all monarch caterpillars ko maar deta tha every few years. Mean butterflies banne se pehle hi bahut sare caterpillars used to die. because of that viral disease. Ibrite thought that disease might be carried by a beetle. तो उन्होंने सोचा शायद एक बीटल, बीटल इज अ रेड कलर इंसेक्ट होता है अगर आपने देखा हो. सो ये बीटल से डेफिनेटली फैलता है जो उनका थॉट था. He tried raising caterpillars in the presence of beetles. So what he did, उन्होंने रियल एक्सपेरिमेंट किया. He brought some beetles and he kept some caterpillars over there and he did the real experiment. I didn't get any real results. तो कोई real results नहीं मिले. That means caterpillar survived in the presence of beetle. That means my idea और my जो एक guess work था that had failed. Means beetle were not the reason for the death of the monarch caterpillars. He said, but why I went ahead? But I went ahead. लेकिन मैंने कहा भी कुछ तो reason होगा. Ensure that I had tried the experiment. और फिर मैं आगे बढ़ा. मैंने इस experiment को दिखाया. And this time I won the for the thing or for this research that beetles are not the reason for the death of monarch caterpillars. Is it clear? Till here, everything is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Are you finding the chapter interesting?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
That's very nice. So the next year, actually science तुम लोगों को पसंद भी काफी होना चाहिए. And science में interest जिन बच्चों का they really love it. And maybe some guidance or guiding factor you can receive from this chapter. You know, curiosity is very important. अभी तो बहुत सारी चीजें आप पढ़ोगे. It's a very long chapter. And you are going to get a lot of hints and indications and guiding force through this. The next year, his science fair project was testing the theory. Next year, yani ninth grade mein jo unka science fair project jo choose kiya, Ibrite ne was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarchs. Ek another species thi butterfly ki, viceroy butterflies, wo copy karti hai monarchs. To badi interesting study hai, dhyan se suniyega, otherwise you will miss it out. So the theory was that ki viceroys look like monarchs. Looks mein ye dekhiye, aapko dikh raha hai? This is जो टॉप पर है ये मोनार्क बटरफ्लाइज है. वॉइसरॉय, ये दिस इज द वॉइसरॉय बटरफ्लाई. यू कैन सी बोथ ऑफ देम. यस. सो अब क्या था, द थ्योरी वाज दैट कि वॉइसरॉय लुक्स वॉइसरॉयज लुक लाइक मोनार्क्स बिकॉज मोनार्क्स डोंट टेस्ट गुड टू बर्ड्स. बर्ड्स को मोनार्क बटरफ्लाइज पसंद नहीं थे, इनका टेस्ट पसंद नहीं था. और दे लाइक टू ईट, बर्ड्स लाइक टू ईट वॉइसरॉय बटरफ्लाइज, राइट. वॉइसरॉयज on the other hand do taste good to birds. So the more they look like monarchs, kyunki wo agar monarchs jaise dikhenge to definitely unke chances kam honge ki wo apni shape ko aise matlab when they used to fly to aisa shape kar lete the ki they should look like monarch butterflies. So birds won't eat them, apni life bachane ke liye wo aisa kiya karte the. So they more look like monarchs, the less likely they are to become birds dinner. To bird ka dinner nahi banenge. Ibrite's project was to see whether in fact birds would eat monarchs. So Ibrite ka project tha ki kya waqai aisa hai ki birds jo hai wo monarchs ko khati. He found that a starling would not eat ordinary bird food. Usne ye dekha starling, one more picture I'm going to show you that. Ye hai aapki starling bird, right? It is found in America. This is the starling bird. So it would it would eat all the monarchs it could get. So ye starling jo hai ordinary bird food nahi khati thi, jo other birds khati thi. Starling ka taste different tha, kuch logon ka taste different hota hai, to he it had a different taste starling bird. So he used to eat, Ibrite ne sirf research kiya, it would eat all the monarchs it could get. Baki sari viceroy khati thi lekin ye monarch khati thi. Sari monarch birds jitni bhi mil jati thi, monarch butterflies, he would eat all of them. So Ibrite said later research by other people showed, Ibrite ने बाद में लिखा कि बाकी लोगों ने जो रिसर्च किया वही दिखाता था वॉइसरॉयज प्रोबेबली डू कॉपी द मोनार्क्स. ऑपोजिट था, वॉइसरॉय कॉपी करती थी मोनार्क्स को, राइट. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड?
यस मैम.
राइट, बिल्कुल ऑपोजिट था. दिस प्रोजेक्ट वाज प्लेस्ड फर्स्ट इन जियोलॉजी डिविजन और ऑब्वियसली एक नई स्टडी थी, क्यूरियोसिटी भी काफी क्लैरिफाई हुआ उनका एंड ही डिस्कवर्ड अ न्यू थिंग. So this project was placed first in the geology division and third overall in the county science fair. So county science fair mein he get the third prize overall and geology department mein first prize. In his second year in high school, yani 10th mein jab wo aaye, Richard Ibrite began the research that led to his discovery of an unknown insect hormone. Ye sabse interesting study hai jisme kafi labor inhone kiya. सो इट वॉज लाइक ए सेकेंड ईयर में उन्होंने देखा कि रिचर्ड डिब्राइट बिगेन कि अननोन इंसेक्ट हार्मोन, एक ऐसा हार्मोन है जो इंसेक्ट्स के अंदर है बट इट इज अननोन, इट हैज नॉट बीन एनालाइज्ड मच. इनडायरेक्टली इट ऑल्सो लेड टू हिज न्यू थ्योरी ऑन द लाइफ ऑफ सेल्स. और इनडायरेक्टली अब जो जिसके लिए वो आज तक जाने जाते हैं, लाइफ ऑफ सेल्स, सेल की वर्किंग कैसे होती है, एक न्यू थ्योरी की तरफ इट वॉज हिज फर्स्ट स्टेप. मीन्स यू कैन से दैट इंसेक्ट हार्मोन, दिस अननोन इंसेक्ट हार्मोन वॉज द स्टेपिंग स्टोन ऑफ हिज बिगेस्ट थ्योरी. The question he tried to answer was simple. एक सिंपल से क्वेश्चन का वो आंसर ढूंढ रहे थे कि what is the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa? तो monarch जब pupa form में होता है तो 12 gold spots होते हैं उसके ऊपर. उसका reason क्या था? Everyone assumed the spots were just ornamental. हर कोई ये assume कर लेता था. Usually those who do not have that science inclination or this kind of curiosity, definitely we would say कि ऐसी खूबसूरत दिखने के लिए, बट नेचर ने, नेचर हैज नॉट क्रिएटेड एनीथिंग विदाउट पर्पस. देयर आर ऑलवेज मेनी पर्पस बिहाइंड द फंक्शन ऑफ नेचर. सो इब्राइट ने कहा, बट डॉक्टर उर्खाट डिडंट बिलीव इट. बट डॉक्टर उर्खाट, बिकॉज ही वाज जस्ट गाइडिंग हिम ऑल थ्रू, सो ही सेड कि ही डिडंट बिलीव दिस. टू फाइंड द आंसर, इब्राइट एंड अनदर एक्सेलेंट साइंस स्टूडेंट फर्स्ट हैड टू बिल्ड अ डिवाइस दैट शोड दैट स्पॉट्स वर प्रोड्यूसिंग अ हार्मोन नेसेसरी फॉर द बटरफ्लाइज full development. सबसे पहले these gold spots were to be shown that actually they are not spots, they are a hormone. Right? ये hormone है जो butterfly के full development के लिए बहुत जरूरी है. The project won Ibright first place in the county fair. और ये first time था, device बनाया, उस device से show किया. Obviously something new was there, experimental था and it was a working project. So, इस प्रोजेक्ट ने फर्स्ट प्लेस पहली बार काउंटी फेयर में मिला एंड एंट्री मिली इनटू द इंटरनेशनल साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग फेयर. साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग फेयर में एंट्री, देयर ही वन थर्ड प्लेस फॉर जियोलॉजी. सो जियोलॉजी में उनको थर्ड प्लेस मिला. ही ऑल्सो गॉट अ चांस टू वर्क ड्यूरिंग द समर एट द एंटोमोलॉजी लेबोरेटरी ऑफ द वॉल्टर रीड आर्मी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ रिसर्च. ये बहुत बड़ा चांस था, यहाँ सारे इक्विपमेंट्स थे विच कुड गिव हिम whole world to work on his project. So many things were available which he needed earlier. So unko chance mila to work summer time mein. Inko jaise ek ro diya gaya, mauka diya gaya, because aapko international fair mein entry mili hai. So summer ke time par entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. As a high school junior, Richard Ibright continues his advanced experiments on the monarch pupa. So, high school senior ho chuke the, abhi Richard Ibright ne apna advanced experiments, jo aage ke experiments se usko continue rakha monarch pupa par. Abhi sirf ye prove kiya gaya tha that 12 tiny gold spots are hormone. But what is the function of that? That still needs to be proved. That year, his project won first place at the International Science Fair and gave him another chance to work in the army laboratory during summer. So summer mein ek aur mauka mila unhe. So first place mila inko International Science Fair mein and another chance to continue his project. In his senior year, he went a step further. And senior year mein aur more success was assured. He grew cells from a monarch wing in a culture and showed that the cells would divide and develop into normal butterfly wing scales only if they fit the hormone from the gold spots. Be very careful with each and every word. Dhyan se samajhiye. He grew cells. Unhone kya proof kiya? He grew cells from a monarch's wing. Unhone cells grow kiye monarch ke wing se in a culture. Culture yani ek particular temperature mein. Ek particular temperature is called and showed that the cells would divide. और ये कहा कि ये जो सेल्स हैं, दे वुड डिवाइड एंड डेवलप इनटू नॉर्मल बटरफ्लाई विंग स्केल्स. जो स्केल्स होते हैं डिफरेंट कलर्स, सो उन स्केल्स में डिवाइड हो जाते हैं ओनली इफ दे वर फेड द हार्मोन फ्रॉम द गोल्ड स्पॉट्स. जो डिफरेंट कलर्स बटरफ्लाई के विंग्स में स्केल्स होते हैं वो दे कुड बी अचीव्ड ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ द हार्मोन दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन द गोल्ड स्पॉट्स. ये द बिगेस्ट डिस्कवरी था अब तक उनका. That project was won first place for geology at the international fair. And this time it brought him a huge success and this project won first place. Keep this. Those firstly, it proved that it is a hormone, and secondly, it was proved that it helped in getting the scales into the butterfly. So he spent the summer after graduation doing further work at the Army Laboratory and at the laboratory of U.S. Department of Agriculture. So after his summer, उन्होंने graduation के बाद आगे का काम किया and Army Laboratory में काम किया at the laboratory of U.S. Department of Agriculture. So he, the wide opportunities were opening for him with every success. The following summer, after his freshman year at Harvard University, Ebright went back to the laboratory of the Department of Agriculture and did more work on the hormone from the goat spots. So still he was not satisfied. He still continued his project on the from the goat spots using the laboratory's sophisticated instruments, because sophisticated are very fine instruments जो available थे laboratory में उनको use किया and he was able to identify the hormone's chemical structure. और hormone का जो chemical structure था इसको decode करने में he became successful, right? उसको पूरा decode कर लिया उन्होंने कि chemical structure क्या है. A year and a half later, और उसके बाद one and a half year के बाद during his junior year, Ebright got the idea for his new theory. एक नई theory के लिए idea मिला, that is about cell life. सेल कैसे काम करते हैं? It came while he was looking at X-ray photos of the chemical structure of a hormone. एक हार्मोन का केमिकल स्ट्रक्चर he was looking and then he reached to the conclusion what actually the cell life is. ये थ्योरी कैसे काम करती है? He wanted to explore this now. When he saw those photos, Ebright didn't shout. He didn't shout. चीखा नहीं. Eureka. Eureka is an victory sign. जब जोर से और इवन कोई नहीं वाओ आई हैव गॉट ही डिडंट गेट दैट एक्साइटेड और इवन आई हैव गॉट इट और ये भी नहीं कि हालांकि इट वाज अ बिग थिंग फॉर हिम बट ही डिडंट शो दैट काइंड ऑफ सरप्राइज दैट काइंड ऑफ हैप्पीनेस और ब्रावो और समथिंग ही डिडंट से एनीथिंग बट ही बिलीव दैट अलोंग विद हिज फाइंडिंग्स अबाउट इंसेक्ट हॉर्मोन्स द फोटोज गिव हिम द आंसर टू वन ऑफ बायोलॉजीज पजल्स. उन्होंने कहा उनकी फाइंडिंग्स के साथ जो इंसेक्ट हॉर्मोन्स की है फोटोज ने उनको एक आंसर दिया है बायोलॉजी के सबसे वन ऑफ द बायोलॉजीज पजल्स को लेकर कि हाउ द सेल कैन रीड द ब्लूप्रिंट ऑफ इट्स डीएनए कि जो सेल है वो अपने डीएनए का ब्लूप्रिंट को कैसे रीड करता है. मीन्स डीएनए से हमको पता चलता है कि ये सेल किसका है एनिमल का है या किसी ह्यूमन बींग का है. डीएनए एक्चुअली इज द सब्सटेंस इन द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ अ सेल दैट कंट्रोल्स हेरिडिटी. आई कैन शो यू द पिक्चर फॉर दैट ऑल्सो जस्ट see this is the cell. Cell ke andar hoga nucleus. Nucleus ke andar chromosome and chromosome mein hota hai DNA. So ye unhone ki yahan se hi wo ye blueprint dekh sakta hai cell aur yahi se jo bhi hereditarily hai hum log ke apne parents se aane wale habits hai jo DNA hamara hai it this cell identifies it through this. To ye bahut bada ek discovery tha unke liye ek bahut bada success tha. Biology ka bahut bada puzzle unhone solve kiya tha. So it determines the form and function of the cell aur yahi determine karta hai ki us cell ka function kya hoga yani heredity kaise karegi aayegi uske andar person ke andar kaise wo inherit karega. Thus dna is the blueprint for life. So this dna decides the life of that insect or any person. Ebright and his college roommate James R. Wong. So inka college mein roommate tha James R. Wong. Worked all that night drawing pictures and constructing plastic models of molecules to show how it could happen. So puri raat ko log baithe rahe unka roommate bhi tha James R. Wong and they were drawing the pictures and constructing plastic models of molecules to show how it could happen. Together they later wrote the paper that explained the theory and phir later on they both wrote the paper aur puri theory ko explain kiya. Surprising, no one who knew him. Richard Ebright graduated from Harvard with highest honors. Surprising ye tha ki no one who knew him, jo bhi log unko jante the ki Richard Ebright ne jab graduation kiya tha Harvard University se to with the highest honors kiya tha. He secured the second place in his class of 1510 students. So surprising, no one knew, kisi ko pata hi nahi, to no one who knew him, kisi ko nahi zyada malum tha ki ye itne brilliant student hai. Ebright went on to become a graduate student researcher at Harvard Medical School एंड फिर उन्होंने साइंटिस्ट बन चुके थे, अब तक बहुत सारी चीजें कर चुके थे. सो ही कंटिन्यूड हिज रिसर्चेस एंड वर्क केप्ट ऑन वर्किंग ऑन हिज थ्योरीज. इफ द थ्योरी प्रूव्स करेक्ट इट विल बी अ बिग स्टेप टुवर्ड्स अंडरस्टैंडिंग द प्रोसेसेस ऑफ लाइफ. और ये सेल लाइफ को अगर पूरा डिकोड कर लिया इन्होंने तो ये बहुत बड़ा स्टेप होगा अंडरस्टैंडिंग द प्रोसेसेस ऑफ लाइफ, जिंदगी की प्रोसेसेस को समझने के लिए. इट माइट आल्सो लीड टू न्यू आइडियाज फॉर प्रिवेंटिंग सम टाइप्स ऑफ कैंसर एंड अदर डिजीजेस. और अगर इसमें सक्सेसफुल रहते तो कुछ और टाइप्स के जो कैंसर हैं या कुछ डिजीजेस हैं उनको रोका जा सकता है. ऑल ऑफ दिस इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज ऑफ इब्राइट्स साइंटिफिक क्यूरियोसिटी. एंड ये तभी हो पाया बिकॉज साइंटिफिक क्यूरियोसिटी दैट वॉज इनबिल्ट in Ebright. For everything he had a curiosity. His high school research into the purpose of the spots on the monarch pupa eventually led him to his theory about cell life. So start hua tha butterflies ke collection se and it led him to the cell theory. So monarch pupa finally uske liye cell life tak pahunche and that is a great thing that happened with Richard Ebright. So Richard Ebright has been interested in science since he first began collecting butterflies. But not so deeply that he has in time for other interests. लेकिन इतना deeply भी उन्होंने नहीं इसको लिया था कि उनके पास और चीजों के लिए वक्त नहीं था. He always took out some time for his hobbies. Ebright also became a champion debater. Debate बहुत अच्छा करते थे. Public speaker थे. He was a good orator as well. Oratory skills were amazing. And a good canoeist. Canoeist is a small light boat होती है, तो canoeing बहुत अच्छी करते थे. And all around outdoors person. और काफी social थे. He is also an expert photographer. Photographer bhi bahut acche the, particularly nature and scientific exhibits. Science, nature se related ya science se related, if he sees anything, scientific exhibits kuch bhi dikhta tha to photograph lena, it was his habit. It was his hobby. In high school, Richard Ebright was a straight student. 10th tak to sirf student the because learning was easy. क्योंकि उनके लिए ब्रिलियंट स्टूडेंट्स के लिए लर्निंग कभी डिफिकल्ट नहीं होता है, लर्निंग इजी था. ही टर्न्ड अ लॉट ऑफ हिज एनर्जी टुवर्ड्स द डिबेटिंग एंड मॉडल यूनाइटेड नेशंस क्लब. स्टडीज तो ऐसे ही हो जाते थे, उन्होंने अपनी ज्यादा एनर्जी को चैनलाइज किया टुवर्ड्स द डिबेटिंग एंड मॉडल यूनाइटेड नेशन क्लब्स. सो मॉडल यूनाइटेड नेशन क्लब्स थे, वहां पर ही क्लब के मेंबर्स बने, डिबेटिंग किया. ही ऑल्सो फाउंड समवन टू एडमायर रिचर्ड एवरिल, हिज सोशल स्टडीज टीचर एंड एडवाइजर टू बोथ क्लब्स. He also found someone to admire. और वो उनको Richard A. Wehrer भी काफी पसंद थे. Richard A. Wehrer उनके social studies के teacher थे. He also liked him very much and advisor भी थे उसके to both the clubs. और दोनों clubs के advisor भी थे. Mr. Wehrer was the perfect person for me then. वो के उस time पर मुझे Mr. Wehrer काफी पसंद थे. He opened my mind to new ideas. Ebright ने कहा, even I got the inspiration from Mr. Wehrer also. Richard would always give that extra effort, Mr. Wehrer said. वो कहते थे हमेशा एक extra effort, ये जो X factor है, that was very active in Ebright. So what pleased me was, और सबसे ज्यादा खुशी मुझे इस बात से होती थी, here was this person who put in 3 or 4 hours at night doing debate research besides doing all his research with butterflies and his other interest. So Mr. Wehrer कहते थे सबसे अच्छी बात इनके बारे में, Ebright के बारे में ये थी कि अपने प्रोजेक्ट्स पर तो थ्योरी पर तो काम करते ही थे, बट इफ ही इज गोइंग टू पार्टिसिपेट इन एनी डिबेट कॉम्पिटिशन तो 3 or 4 hours वो आपको जरूर देते थे डूइंग डिबेट रिसर्च बिसाइड्स डूइंग ऑल हिज रिसर्च विद बटरफ्लाइज एंड दूसरे इंटरेस्ट को परस्यू करना. मेनी थिंग्स ही वर डूइंग एट द सेम टाइम, मल्टीटास्किंग ही कुड डू, एंड अ पर्सन हु कैन डू द मल्टीटास्किंग डेफिनेटली ही इज अ सक्सेसफुल मैन. रिचर्ड वाज कॉम्पिटिटिव और मिस्टर वीरर कंटिन्यू करते हैं कि बहुत कॉम्पिटिटिव था, दैट वी गॉट द आइडिया इन द वेरी स्टार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर ऑल्सो, कि बहुत कॉम्पिटिटिव नेचर बहुत था, बट नॉट इन अ बैड सेंस. लेकिन बैड सेंस में नहीं था, ही वॉज नॉट अ बैड कॉम्पिटिटर, अच्छे सेंस में था कि ही ऑलवेज लव टू इम्प्रूव हिमसेल्फ, अपने आप को डिमोरलाइज नहीं करना उनको, रादर ही टुक द इंस्पिरेशन. इफ आई हैव लॉस्ट देन ही वुड एक्सप्लोर द रीजंस फॉर हिज लॉस और फॉर हिज व्हाई ही लॉस्ट the particular competition, uski failure ka reason kya tha, he would explore that and then he would calculate the things very seriously and put in more positive efforts to be a successful man in the next task on the next challenge that comes in his way. So he explained Richard wasn't interested in winning or winning six or winning to get a prize. Richard's सिर्फ जीतने में इंटरेस्टेड नहीं थे, सिर्फ जीतना ही पर्पस नहीं था या फिर प्राइज जीतना नहीं था, रादर ही वॉज विनिंग बिकॉज ही वॉन्टेड टू द बेस्ट जॉब ही कुड, बिकॉज वो बेस्ट के लिए ट्राई करते थे, राइट? ही वॉज विनिंग बिकॉज ही वॉन्टेड टू डू द बेस्ट जॉब ही कुड फॉर द राइट रीजन ही वॉन्ट्स टू बी द बेस्ट, और अच्छे रीजन के लिए वो अच्छे बनना चाहते थे, एंड इट वॉज द वंडरफुल थिंग, एंड दैट इज वन ऑफ द इनग्रीडियंट्स इन द मेकिंग ऑफ अ साइंटिस्ट, और यही इनग्रीडियंट्स हैं किसी भी साइंटिस्ट की मेकिंग में. Ingredients means the necessary items, the necessary things, the necessary factors which should be present in a scientist. Start with a first rate mind. सबसे important जो आपको बता रहे पहले, you should have a first rate mind. That means a brilliant mind you should have. Second, you should have the curiosity. And third, mixing in the will. Third thing is the will. आपके अंदर you should have that that spark. You should have that fire in you. To win for the right reasons. Jealous नहीं होना है, किसी को demotivate नहीं करके जीतना है या किसी को let down करके नहीं जीतना है. You should win for your own reasons. If right has these qualities and all these qualities were in fine proportion in Richard Ebright, and that's why he was a successful scientist. He is a successful scientist. From the time the book The Travels of Monarch 10 opened the world of science to him, Richard Ebright has never lost his scientific curiosity. Rather, it kept on adding, and definitely it brought a huge success for this man, for this scientist. And that's why we are reading this chapter. This chapter has been given to you all, young minds, to provide you the inspiration that develop this curiosity. Right? I hope you enjoyed and you learned something today.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good, that's great. And if we are learning, then definitely what we are doing, we are opening a new scenario for us. We are opening new world for us, and that world is of success, right?